God, our Father, we come before you and say thank you, O God. Thank you for these night gifts that are presented before you, O God. May this gift, God, before you be pressed down, shaken, and running over. May it glorify you, O God, and do more in the kingdom of God. This is my prayer, God, in the name of Christ Jesus, our Savior. Amen.
Amen.
Let's feel, thank
you. Let's feel, Jesus.
Psalms 30. Psalms 30, verse 5. Coming from the Christian Standard Version, verse 5. For his anger lasts only a moment.
Yes,
sir. But his favor, a lifetime. Weeping may stay over.
Yes, sir. All right.
There is joy King James, for his anger is only for a little while.
Yes, sir.
A little bit, yeah.
His favor is a lot.
Yes, sir.
Weeping may endure for a night.
Yes, sir.
Joy comes in. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, the morning is coming.
The morning is coming.
Come on now. Come on.
Yes.
We as children of God, we as followers and believers of Jesus Christ, we see God and we understand God to be a kind, loving, gentle, merciful, and a just God. We really never hear or talk about God getting and being angry. When talking about God or hearing someone else talk about God, you always hear how good God is. We don't ever talk about the other side of God. Every now and then, God has to show that other side, and he is forced to use the rod of correction on his children. Just like any other good parent, God does get angry. But his anger is only but for a moment. The Israelites stayed in trouble with God because of their disobedience. David, while on the way to the city of David with the Ark of the Covenant, doesn't follow God's instructions on how to handle the Ark and decides to put it on a cart. While on their way, the cart hits a bump in the road and the Ark begins to sway back and forth. Uzzah decides to touch the Ark with his hands so that it wouldn't fall. God gets angry and kills Uzzah right there on the spot. When we are done wrong by a person, we immediately start plotting ways to get that person back. He hit me, so I'm going to hit him back. She pushed me, so I'm going to push her back. She tripped me, so I'm going to trip her up. Some of us Christians believe and think that God is going to do us like we do him. When someone makes us mad, we tend to hold grudges against that person. We don't speak to that person. We don't talk to that person. When we see them, block and delete them from Facebook, block and delete them from your contacts. You must realize and understand is that we all have done things to God, whether we realize it or not. We've done things that has made God angry. The way we have treated God, if getting his lick back was a part of his makeup, we'd all be in a lot of trouble. But thanks be unto God, his anger is only for a moment.
Somebody ought to just shout that his anger is only for a moment. His anger don't last always. His anger is only for a moment, but his favor is a life. Favor and grace are combined as one. Grace is God's unmerited favor. And merited means that favor is not deserved. I don't know about you and how you may feel about it, but I'm glad that God's favor is on, in, and over my life. From the time that I was born until the time that I spent my last breath, God's favor is over my life. I don't deserve his favor. I'm not worthy of his favor. But because he loves me, and because I'm his child, I've got God's favor. You're not deserving of God's favor either. You're not worthy of it. But his favor is for life. And because his favor is for life, doors are going to be opened for you because of God's favor. Ways will be made for you because of God's favor. What we must realize and understand is that people aren't going to like you because of the favor of God that's on your life. Repeat after me, favor ain't fair. Favor ain't fair. I don't think that neighbor hurts you, so touch your other neighbor and say, favor ain't fair. It's going to look like your life is going from bad to worse because of everything that you are facing. It's going to seem and look like you can't even catch a break. But when God shows his favor, what you went through, it'll be worth it all. Because of God's favor, he keeps blessing me over and over. I can't explain it. It's not by any goodness of my own. But I'm so glad that his favor is for life. Amen. Touch your neighbor just one more time and say, neighbor,
neighbor.
I've got favor.
I've got favor.
Yes,
favor.
Yes,
thank you.
His anger is only but for a moment. His favor is life. Weeping may endure for a night. What you must realize and understand is that this thing called life will have you weeping. Weeping over relationships that have ended or that is ending. Weeping over a long-term job that went bankrupt. Another word for endure is short-lived. Short-lived means lasting only a short time. Weeping won't always last. It's only meant to be lived a short time. Weeping is only short-lived because the real resident is about to take over. The real resident that is supposed to be there is on their way back, and they're coming back to stay. Weeping may endure for a night. Weeping may endure for a night. Somebody say that. Weeping may endure for a night. But here's the shouting news. Joy comes in. There is an in-between time between weeping and joy. While weeping is setting up residence permanently, you already know that weeping is temporary. So you can go ahead and shout about the fact that what's to come is right around the corner. While weeping is still setting up residence, you don't have to wait until weeping is completely gone. You can go ahead and shout right now. Oh, I wish I had somebody that don't mind giving God praise while it's still dark, while it's still this or anywhere, because you know that joy is coming. I've got to leave you alone. But when joy comes, it brings peace. When joy comes, it brings happiness. The light is no longer there because joy has overshadowed the darkness. This joy that I have, the world didn't give it to me, and the world can't take it away. Well, this joy had to come from somewhere. You didn't just get this joy by osmosis. It had to come from somewhere. So this joy that I have, this peace that I have, this happiness that I have, it came from the one who sits high and looks low. Came from the one who sits on the right side of the Father. Came from the one who came down through 42 generations to be born of a virgin named Mary. Walked in the dust districts of Galilee for 33 and a half years, still in the sick, raising the dead, giving sight to the blind, unstopping deaf ears. He is the great I am. He is the Lord of the valley. He is the light and the morning. He is Alpha and Omega. He is the beginning. And he is the Lord of the Spirit. Is there anybody here to know who I'm talking about? He's the one who knew no sin, but took on the sin of the world. He died out on a hill called Calvary, but the story doesn't end right there, because Calvary, Sunday morning, he got up with all power in his hand. Well, this joy comes from the one. He is Adam's Redeemer. He's Abel's Vindicator. He's Noah's Ark. He's Abraham's sacrifice. He's Moses' bush on fire. He's Joshua's battle axe. He's Gideon's peace. He's Samson's power. He's David's music. He's Solomon's wisdom. He's Jeremiah's promise in the head. He's Ezekiel's real in the middle of the river. He's Joseph's crown down in the valley. He's Daniel's stone rolling down on the mountain. He's Matthew's king. He's Mark's suffering servant. He's Luke's great physician. He's God's word made flesh. He's my way in. He's my way out.
Yeah.
but I can't call on nobody else. It's Jesus.
Yes. Yes, sir.
Is there anybody here that know anything about the name Jesus? He walks with me. And he talks with me. Tells me I am his own.
Being preached this day. God has blessed us to hear the word of God this day. Thank him for it. Brother Kwan.
I'm the one. Jesus' name I do